See all this? Kind of looks like we're underway. But nope, we're tied up to this ship and stapled in anchorage, and they're moored, and we're bunkering them. Just wanted to show you how much tide runs through stapled in anchorage here at New York Harbor. Now, I know there are other places in the world where tide runs a lot harder than that, but this is what we're dealing with. And in this case, tide's going to be my friend, because it's going to be real easy to pull off this ship. We'll let the lines go in the stern. We'll crack the bow open. The water will go in between the ship and the barge. We should peel right off. So come along, let's go.
Welcome to TimBatSea. I'm not Tim. This is your favorite deckhand Dalton, coming to you live from Stapleton Anchorage alongside a ship here. Just wanted to take a second and say appreciate all the love and the comments I got on that last video, except for that one head who said he didn't like the video. You know who you are. I'm not mad about it. Just know, I'll find you. Okay? I will find you.
Hello and welcome. Actually, I think Dalton already welcomed you guys. Before any of you guys get mad and the YouTube police come after me, it's satire. He's joking, all right? No reason to get upset. Anyway, welcome to TimBatSea, and it's getting to be really exciting. It's the 31st today, which is Halloween, and I'm not excited about Halloween. I'm excited because I've got 10 more days left on the tugboat, and then me and my crew, not the crew on this boat, but the crew on SV Paquita, all head south and get on the sailboat SV Paquita that's down in Deltaville, Virginia right now. And if the weather's right and everything's good, we head for a 1500 mile ocean crossing to Puerto Rico. We're gonna go and not go down the coast, not do the intercoastal. We're gonna head off to Bermuda and then straight down. So that ought to be interesting. If you haven't checked out my other channel, please do. I can really use your help. You can go over there and help. I've got some content up there, and as we go through, I'll be doing all kinds of content for this whole trip going down there. But it's obviously YouTube, and just type in SV space Paquita, and it should come up. And thank you so much. So, what do we got today? Well, we are over at the bottom of Bay Ridge Anchorage, and there's a big tanker here, and we're letting lines go. We've just given them some go juice. And we have to go to another ship, but the other ship isn't ready yet. It has to leave where it is over in at Bayway and go all the way down the Ortherkills, all the way around Staten Island, come back up into the harbor, anchor, and then we'll go to that. So that might be, I don't even think they leave until like another hour from now, and that might be, so it might be about 3 or 4 hours before they're ready. So we're gonna go over to a lay berth and lay up over there. I've already checked in with traffic and given them our dimensions and where we're going and that sort of stuff. And I've been telling you guys this for a while, but just in case somebody hasn't seen it, there's, if you want to know what VTS is, it's Vessel Traffic Services. It's basically the maritime equivalent of ATC. VTS helps us. It tells us who's coming and going and all that. And it's something that's kind of, it's something that I've dealt with for my entire career. And what's kind of cool is that we were able to get granted permission to get into us. Say again?
You see anybody walking around up there?
Yeah, they're just sitting there. He's just looking at you. Right where you're at. I'll blow the horn. Yeah, he's looking back and forth, but he's right up against the manifold. He's not coming to the edge. So we're trying to let the lines go, and apparently there's a guy on the ship that's not understanding what we need to do. But anyway, we were granted access to film in a secure military facility, something that doesn't happen every day and something I'm really grateful for. The video, you can see, I was an ultimate fanboy there. I was very enthusiastic, and I had a lot of grief in the comments about that. But guilty as charged, I was very happy to be there. And if you want to see what BTS does behind the scenes, I recommend that you go and check it out. And I'll try to put a link in the description if I remember. All right, on with this particular job. So since we've blown the horn and he just looks around, maybe he can understand English. Hello, on the deck. Hey, can you come to the rail? Hello. Hey. Oh, come over. Yep, you. Yep. That's it. Come on over. You can do it. There you go. All right. Look at the guy down in the barge. See the guy in the barge? What's he saying, Dalton?
Nothing.
It looks like he's looking for orders.
He said something about the captain was the reason, but I don't see how that could be a problem, because they called me on my radio, asked me to hurry up with the letter of protest because the pilot's about to come aboard. I said please and everything.
Good for you. Yes, sir. Here we go. All right, it looks like they got things underway. Here we go. Lines are dropping in the water. Make a security call. Security call, Black Elk River. Signaling up line ship side, lower end of Bay Ridge. Headed over for Gowanus. Tug Elk River.
Elk River.
Thank you for the last time now.
Very good. That's my buddy Sean.
My son watches all your videos.
All right. That's nice. All right, we'll call it 10:30 underway.
10:30 underway.
So now,
this
barge doesn't have any rubber on the corner of it. It's got a Yokohama up on the stern. So I got to be really careful putting the stern up against here because it will go metal to metal. All right, I'm just going real easy so I don't go metal to metal.
Yeah, that's a lot of touch back there.
Okay, I'm just about ready to touch, so I'm going to lift off the stern a little bit. There we go. I lift off the stern by giving just a little bit of left wheel.
Where are we going? Is that shipping yet?
Nope, and it looks like it's not going to be in for a while, and unfortunately, we got to do some shuffling.
So you and I are going to put this thing over to Henry Street, and then hopefully it'll be the other crew, but another tug is going to bring another barge out that has to go on the inside of this, but it won't be for an hour and a half, so it doesn't make sense to float around for an hour and a half, so we'll go there, put up a couple lines, then probably around 12 o'clock or so, they'll do the old swap-a-roo.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so a little bit. I was talking about that before, that there's enough tide here so that I can crack the bow open without jamming the stern into the ship.
If Mike stay will have to display a deal head down there.
Yeah, we could do that. We'll take a look at it when we get over there.
Even though the port later is a 38, I don't know if you want to run it by feet or anything.
Yeah, we'll take a look at it, make sure nobody's over there. Yeah, so I crack the bow open a little bit and I let get that tide, and the tide comes in between the ship and the barge, and it will start to pull us off. Otherwise, if I went hard over like that, we'd jam the stern right in and we'd go metal to metal. So I just crank it a little bit like that, get the tide in between it, and starts lifting off, and then now we're peeling away. So we're writing the log. And we'll take a look at things when we get over there. All right.
Okay, so we're coming to the entrance of Gowanus Bay. And I don't know if you guys can see it or not, but there's a dredge working up there. And what these dredges do to move around, this is actually what we call a spud dredge. It has spuds, big things that stick in the bottom and hold them in place. But they have four anchors, and they lift up the spuds, and they'll pull on the anchors to move the dredge around, and then they reposition it. So it's important that I don't run over the anchor wires, because that would be really bad. So what we do is we call them, and then he relaxes the wires, and we go over the top. And he doesn't move while that's happening, because he's got these spuds down in place. So I need to call him right now. I think we're all set, but I just need to make sure.
Do you understand right now, or Brooklyn?
Paula Lee, Elk River. Hey, Cap. Coming into Gowanus, parcel loaded bunker barge on the nose. Can I get through on the south side?
South side's open. Take all the everything on your port side.
Very good. Thank you so much. All right. So now I've just confirmed with him that if we go south of him and take everything, all of his buoys on the port side will be fine. I came through here the other night and his buoys were right up against the seawall, so wouldn't have been able to do that then, but now it's moved a little bit, so I think we're going to be all right.
Just coming in on the range, I'm taking your berth, so I'll see you on one when you get
You know, it's kind of interesting. You learn things about yourself when you're out to sea. For years, I used to love work. I'd work over all the time. I was really happy here. Then I got divorced. And became really happy in my personal life. And kind of taking the shine off the work. Now, I'm not saying it's not a great job. And I'm not saying that I love it. All of that is true. But man, my time off is becoming more and more valuable to me. Now with a great boat. Oh, and a new person in my life doesn't hurt either. Getting all excited. Can't wait for this epic trip. The culmination of about 30 or 40 years of dreaming of this. Now it's going to happen in just 10 days. God willing. Now, I'm sure it doesn't come up on the camera, but if you look, you can see a big barge just forward and to the left a little bit. On the other side of that barge is a big crane. That's the dredge. The dredge loads that barge up until that barge is almost sunk. Then if you look to the right of our barge, straight ahead, there's a yellow buoy up there, and that's marking one of his four anchors. And if you look to the left of the dredge, you'll see a yellow one up against the seawall, and then a rusted one that was yellow at one time that's closer to us. But we're saying we're going to leave all those. And then there should be a fourth one that we can't see that's on the other side. So between those four things, he should have enough, he should be able to move his dredge any way that he wants between those four anchors. All right, Dalton, we're getting close. Dalton, you on this one?
I'm a Fort McHenry, the HMS Justice.
Fort McHenry. Hey, good morning, Cats. We're going to see you over there. Anybody in 7-5?
Hey, Dalton.
Yeah.
We're getting close. So there, once again, I don't know that you can see it, but right behind the dredge, you can see the fourth anchor ball over there.
Good morning, Miss Alexander.
Hey, Captain. Take a block. I can see you. It
was perfect. Thank you very much.
Right.
If I had a hand... I got you, man. Negative, because we're going to have to go there eventually, but because we're going to go up against the bulkhead and then have to leave when the other barge, the 40's coming in, so we're going to go over to Hess. We'll leave it there. They'll come over. We'll put ours outside of theirs, and then we got to break down and leave it. Well, we don't, but the other watch will have to do that.
All right, Project. What side are we laying on to Hess,
Doc? Your side right there, starboard side. So, Dalton and I are in an interesting predicament. He's a phenomenal deckhand. And I mean really, really, really good at his job. But it's also time for him to move up. And he's got his licensing in order, and he's training with me, and he's going to move up. Any day now, I'm going to lose him because he's going to go in the training, in the full-time training program. He's just training with me to get a jump on it, so when he goes in the training program, he won't be in there that long. And I'm happy to train him because he's so good at what he does, and he's eager to learn. He's a great student. But what that really means is that sooner or later, I'm not going to be able to utilize him on deck anymore. And he's really good. And that's what happens, you know. If you have somebody that sucks and never moves up, then you're stuck with them forever. But if you get good guys and they get better and they advance themselves, I like to think that a little part of you is with them forever. I know I've been talking to you guys for years about my Portuguese captain that taught me everything I knew, and I hope that maybe one or two things that I might have said or done along the way sticks with some of these young guys as they come up through. I say Dalton's one of those guys that I think he said in his video the other day that he's 24 years old. He's got a long career ahead of him, and he is really, really dialed in. There are guys that are 40 years old that aren't as dialed in as he is already, and he's going to do very, very well. So you can see that big gray ship. Whenever I come over here, everyone asks if that's military. No, that's not military. That's just old. In fact, I don't think that ship is can be certified that it's ready to go to sea, you know, that it's utilized as a floating storage container. So it's filled with dry cement, the powdered cement, and it's filled with that. They bring a big barge there and they load it up with like 10 or 12,000 tons of powdered, you know, cement, and then trailer trucks come in and get it and they fill those big silos up with it. So that's what that thing's doing there. And then you can see the dock that's right next to it, to the left of it. That's where this barge is ultimately going. The problem is that it's very hard. The way that dock is set up, it's the bollards are inboard of everything, and there are these big tires that hold you off the dock. So it's a big deal. You got to get somebody on the dock to actually catch lines for it. And we're only keeping this here for about an hour until another tug is coming that is going to be utilized after this one will. So tug and barge, they're going to go up against that empty dock. We're going to leave this dock that we're headed to right now and go outboard of them. And that way, when we leave, they'll still be there. I just didn't want to have to go through all the ordeal of going to a dock where we have to put somebody on the dock and that sort of stuff and move around and all that. So we're just going to this one here just to lay up for, like I say, just a half hour, 45 minutes, maybe an hour, until the other tug and barge come. So now I'm all stopped. We're doing 2.9 knots. I got the rudder hard over to port. Now it's a loaded barge, and the wind has kind of set me on the dock. So I'm going to start twisting to lift that bow out because we've got a pretty steep angle right now. I want to flatten out a little bit because, like I say, we do have some product on board.
60 wide, 20 to 55.
Oh, right.
55 wide, coming in 50.
So now, by doing a left twist with the rudder hard over, I'm lifting the bow out, putting the stern over, and we're just flattening out. And because I still want to get up to the dock, I want to get up to the dock. By the time I'm up there, I want to be flat. Now he's saying 35, so I'll give it another little twist. See, if I flatten out right now, it'll take a long time to get over to the dock. So I want to get close to the dock, but still give myself enough time to flatten out. 20 on the bow. All right. So now we're into 20 feet. This is where I have to start really down to 15. So I'm really starting to pay attention now. So what I have to do is I have to come ahead on my engine to get the bow to lift out and push the stern over.
10 wide on the bow, so we're coming
into 8. 10 wide on the bow, we're doing a knot and a half. And we're still swinging all the time. Everything's looking good. Now I'm going to all stop.
6 on the stern.
6 on the bow, 20 on the stern. Moving ahead at 1.2. I think we're looking pretty good.
6 wide on the bow, coming
into
5.
I'm going to give it one more shot to keep that bow off because we're getting really flat. And with any dock like this, that has a, hey, just to give you a heads up, I need to come ahead about 30 or 40 feet so that I don't stick out in the channel.
Okay.
Okay, so now we're just about flat, so I got to reset my rudder to slow my stern down, because my stern is going... My stern is crabbing in towards the dock. There we go. Now I'm trying to twist the stern over to slow it down. All right, we're good right here. You can tie her up just like this.
All right, we're just abreast of this fleet, so if we just keep sliding ahead here, we'll get a forward spring on it.
Okay.
Okay, look out on Big Creek.
All right, we got this line off. We'll wrap it up on the jumper hedge right here.
Beautiful.
Security, HMS Justice, single on that blinds door, port light one on the hip. Be eastbound right, for IMTT con hook, 7-5.
All right, very good. I'll drive into that.
It's a breath line now, slowly coming ahead, turning into a forward lead.
And we check out with traffic. Traffic from the Elk River.
Our forward spring is slowly coming
river.
We're all secure in Gowanus. You can check me out.
Checked out.
Thank you. Now I'm just slowly bumping it ahead just to come into that line, but I don't want to put too much pressure on it, especially because we're kind of just visiting this dock here just for a few minutes. I don't want to put too much pressure on anything. I want to make sure that we leave and they never knew we were here. Very good, and like I said, it's only going to be about an hour, so you don't have to put 10,000 lines out. And that's about it. Anyway, thank you so much for coming along. Your to-do list, if you haven't seen the VTS video, go ahead and look for that. Put the description below. If you haven't checked out SV Paquita, please help me out. God, that sounds pathetic, doesn't it? Anyway, if you'd like to, it's a different channel than this, and that's kind of the purpose of it, is to try to be a little different. Anyway, go see SV Paquita. I'll put a link in that below, too. And maybe you can like, comment. If you haven't subscribed, subscribe. And if you want to be a part of the crew, head on over to Patreon and type in TimBatSea. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, see you on the next one.